الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله ولا اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا إنك سميع مجيب الدعاء ومن يعود بك من علم لا ينفع وقلب لا يخشع ونفس لا تشبع ودعاء لا يسمع. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. الحمد لله رب العالمين. ربي لك الحمد برباك. الحمد لله رب العالمين. We're continuing to learn from his book, and I chose Surah Yasin for many reasons. One of the most common reason, or the number one reason, is because it's a very popular surah. Everybody knows Surah Yasin, and no one in this room don't know there is a surah, a chapter in the Quran called Yasin. Am I correct? Right. But if I tell you there is a chapter, let's say called At-Taghabun, you're gonna say At-Taghabun. Where is that? Right. So Alhamdulillah, which is good. So we really need to learn at least the ones that we are very comfortable or familiar with. Number one. Number two, because there is a lot of controversy about reading Surah Yasin. And this is one of the things I wanted to clarify today, bi-idhnillah. Two. And number three, so it has a lot of virtues. And it is beautiful. It's a short surah, relatively. It's not too long. It's relatively short, but it's very powerful. And this is why you will find probably the most common, I think it is the most common surah, where there is many hadith about its virtues, regardless of the strength of the hadith. I'll come to it and I'll give it to you all. But it's probably the surah that has the most common hadith. And I looked it up, subhanAllah. So there is something about it. So let's start, bismillah. How many of you are familiar with Surah Yasin? Raise your hand. Yeah, especially the Indo-Pak people. So I really, inshallah, one of you teach me, because it is also virtuous in other parts of the world. But in the Indo-Pak part, that part of the world, it's much more, I wouldn't say virtuous to them, but it's something I think they teach you since you were young. Walillah alhamd, at least it's something good and beautiful. So let's, number one, it's a surah. Was it Makki or Madani? Let's see how much you will. Makki. Everybody agree? I don't know. I'm not hearing anything. Yes or no? Yes, absolutely. There is one, and it's a weak opinion, that is one verse maybe was revealed in Medina. But the majority agree it was surah revealed in Mecca. Why do I need to know that? Let's remind ourselves. Because that means when I am weak, when I am here living in this country in this day and age, my iman is weak. I am so indulged or drained by this life, Surah Yasin remind me, don't waste your time and energy. There is much better waiting for you. It has one of the most beautiful, beautiful, to me at least, way of saying, if you only know what is waiting for you there. You all know this. When the man came, and no name for this man in the surah, and he was telling his people, believe in Allah, worship Him. And they made fun of him. I'm not going to tell you because we're going to go into the details. But they made fun of him. And actually, they killed him. Right? And Allah didn't say they killed him, because immediately the scene goes to the hereafter. What did he say? This is one of the most beautiful. He said, وَقَالَ يَا لَيْتَ قَوْمِي يَعْلَمُونَ. Ah, I wish my people know what I am seeing. Like, you know, when you are traveling and you go to some place which is really beautiful, and then you text somebody or you send them messages or you send a picture and you say, if you only know how beautiful is this. How do you feel? You answer, I wish, can you take me? Can I come? That's what he said. And he was talking about the Day of Judgment there on Jannah. So this is one of the most beautiful things in it. It reminds you, there's a lot of talk about Al-Akhirah, talk about the Quran, talk about death and dying, and talk about a human being. And I'll give it to you, so at least you will get familiar to it. So it was revealed in Mecca, and it was sent or revealed to Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam just before he migrated to Medina. Now, think with me. Before he migrated to Medina, what was he going through? Very tough times, right? His wife, Sayyidah Khadija, died. Abu Talib died, right? And none or disbelievers in Mecca literally leashed their anger against him. So he, at one point, and then he went to Ta'if and came back, and nobody believed in him. So he, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Yasin to him. Meaning, there's something in that surah also calm me down and gives me hope. So put this in your mind as we are going to go through it one by one. Number three in this, and it is revealed in the, not in the sequence of the Quran. In the sequence it was revealed, it's after Surah Al-Jinn. So Surah Al-Jinn way in the end of the Quran, 28th, Surah Yasin in the 22nd and 23rd part of the Quran. The 23rd part of the Quran starts in the middle of Surah Yasin. And that teaches you the sequence of the Quran that we see now is not the same sequence that the verses or the chapters were revealed. For example, Baqarah was not number two. Baqarah, in fact, was revealed in Medina. Number one is Iqra. And where is Iqra in the sequence of the Quran? Way at the end. That's something you need to learn. The way it was revealed is not the same way it is the sequence currently. Why? Allah knows. That's a good one. That's a very good one. You never go wrong when you say Allah knows. But why? Who made this sequence? Who made this sequence? Ay, ay, ay. A human being made this sequence? Of course. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He revealed, Sayyidina Uthman compiled it as a book. That's why it's called the Mus'haf al-Uthmani. But when any verse was revealed, Allah told through, of course, Sayyidina Jibreel, Rasul alayhi salam, put it here, put it there. Put it here, put it there. So this sequence is, as the ulama, the scholars teaches you, tawqifi. It's from Allah. I can't change. I can't say Iqra was the first one I'm going to put in the beginning of the Quran. No, because it's not my book or yours. So learn this. So it was revealed after al-jinn, though it was after Fatir in the sequence of the Quran. طيب. What does it talk about? Quran, and I'll give you the numbers of the verses so you can put this, so when we talk, you learn. It talks about the Quran. It starts by the Quran, actually. It's an oath by the Quran. Wal Quran al-Hakim, the wise Quran. So number two, and then there's talk about the Quran later in verses 69 and 70 only. So that's number one, Quran. There's a lot of Allah creation in Surah Yasin. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used two ways. And I want you all, especially us living here in a beautiful place, remember this. When Allah in the Quran says to you, أَوَلَمْ يَرَوْا أَوْ أَلَمْ تَرَى, don't they see? Don't you see? He say this repeatedly in the Quran. That means, why don't you see? For example, if you come in here, right? And I see somebody in the back and I say, there is a chair here. Don't you see it? Meaning, it's very clear. Come. So when you read the Quran, whether in Arabic or in English, and when you see Allah says, don't you see, meaning open your eyes and see. Because when you see, you will change. When you see, you will learn. So there is a lot of alam tara, alam yaraw. But one of the unique of Surah Yasin, there is wa'ayatun lahum, a sign for them, a sign for them. And you know what's the signs? Things that we see every single day and we pay zero attention to it. Who can give me an example? It's in Surah Yasin. Ash-shamsu wal-qamar. Aw lam yaraw anna wash-shamsu tajri li mustaqarrin laha dhalika taqdiru al-aziz al-alim wal-qamara qaddarnahu manazila hatta 'ada kal-urjun al-qadim. A lot of scientific miracles in it. And Allah describes the moon. Don't they see? We have the sun, the sign for them, the sun. Shamsu tajri, sun is running. We'll come to it in detail and get to that. But look at all the signs, ayah, the word ayah. Wa ayatun lahum, a sign for them. Meaning, when I see the sun, I just don't look at it. Oh, it's hot. Oh, today's cloudy. Then I didn't see. Neither I saw, nor it's a word, nor it is a sign for me. And why a sign is important? What did you have for dinner? You're all too quiet. Or you didn't have dinner yet, so you're hungry. What does it mean when Allah says, wa ayatun lahum, a sign for them? meaning meaning see it give it a little bit of time and think of Allah. By the way, everything around us is a sign. You are a sign. Me and you are signed to each other, us as a human being. The phone that we all are addicted to is a sign. Is this small thing, has everything. I can communicate with everybody on this earth. I can see anything. I can run a whole business in this small thing. 50 years ago, if you say this to anybody, they will go crazy. So ayah meaning learn, see, reflect, ponder, change. You put all this together. And very common in Surah Yasin. Another thing, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, very interesting. There is no name of a prophet in Surah Yasin. There isn't. There's just an indirect mention of the Ark of Noah. Beautiful description of Jannah. Not Jannah, the people of Jannah. May Allah make you and me. Inna ashab al Jannah, the dwellers of Jannah. What are they doing? Literally, it's all enjoyment. They are so busy having fun. Literally, that's what Allah says. Inna ashab al Jannah fi shughlin, inna ashab al Jannah al yawma fi shughlin fakihun. The people of Jannah today, they are very busy having fun. Honestly, fakihun meaning they are enjoying. You know, we say, I'm so busy, I have so many things, look at my list. So what do I do now? Do this fun or that fun? Only in Jannah. So that's one of the beautiful things. Another thing, which is the end of it, the last verses in it, how argumentative we are. And we're going to come to it in detail, why this was revealed. Oh, lam yara al-insan. Don't the human beings see what did you we created you from? So look at it. It's only 4.5 pages, very small. I mean, it's not a long, but it's very powerful. And for those of you who know it, especially in the Arabic language, it's very powerful. The words that Allah used in it, what we say, سَهْلُ الْمُمْتَنَةِ, it's easy, but it's very hard to make it. And you can't write it. All the Quran you can, but you cannot even use it as eloquent as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used, and especially in Yasin. Clear? Now let's come to the controversy. What is the virtue of Surah Yasin? Bismillah, you all know it when you were young. What is the virtue of Surah Yasin? Okay, can somebody raise their hand, please? Yeah, oh, somebody sent them? Maybe I know. Bismillah. So it's the heart of the Quran. Yes or no?
Yes.
And how many say yes? Very confident. Okay. This is what I want you to know. There is about, there's at least 10 hadiths about the virtues of Surah Yasin. About 10, relatively. I'll share with you. What is the issue with those hadith? There is not a single one that is sahih. Not a single one that is sound. That's number one. That's why when you say Yasin, the heart of the Quran, some people will look at you and says, ah, don't say that, right? And some people will give you the look. And someone says, yeah. I'll get you to this. This is what I want today. Today I want you to know what has been said about Surah Yasin. And the most beautiful thing when I was preparing this is one of the new scholars, he died, may Allah give him Jannah al-Firdaus, his daughter was actually my fiqh teacher, who he said, there is so many hadiths about Surah Yasin that there has to be a virtue of the surah. Although they are weak, but has to be something special about this surah, this chapter, because there's nowhere else, no other chapters in the Quran has that many. Are you with me? So let's start with this. It does have a virtue, but let's not specify it, because some of those hadiths are rejected, fabricated. And this is something I want all of us to learn, especially in this day of age or forward. And especially when we don't have a lot of knowledge, don't you forward. And please listen to me because I'm going to tell you why. Don't you forward the hadith of saying hadith of a Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam, and you are not sure it's a hadith. Because there is a hadith saying about the person who say this. and it's a hadith mutawatir, meaning highest level of soundness, whomsoever say a lie about me. Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam saying this, let him or her see my place, her place or his place in the hellfire. من كذب علي متعمدا فليتبوأ مقعده من النار. حديث متواتر. هذا one is the highest level of strength. So when you read a hadith, right, especially when you don't have a lot of knowledge, especially in English, because you don't know that how did he exactly say, and you are not sure, they send it to you without a source, don't forward it to anybody. Don't. And if someone responded and said to you, this is not a sound hadith, or this is, if they say the word fabricated, mawdu' or munkar, you need to remove it. That means no way he has said it. Just quickly, I don't want to make it a hadith class, but just quickly for you, hadiths are levels. Like, you know, when may Allah forgive me, but just to make everybody understand, when you see reviews, right, and there is a 5-star, or 4, or 3, or 2, 1, right? The hadith of Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam is this way. When you put 5, mean mutawatir. Very, most probably, almost mutawatir, almost 100% he said it in this way. Then you get to sahih, sound, more than 90% he said it. And then as you go, it gets less. But when it comes to munkar, rejected, or mawdu', fabricated, he did not say it, period. So be very careful. Then you come to Hassan, وحسنٌ لغيري, weak, weak. That doesn't mean he didn't say it, but the possibility is not very strong. But there is a possibility he said it. Are you all with me? So now let's go to see what is said about Surah Yasin. The first one, which we all know, and I'm probably gonna come, yeah. The one, إِنَّ لِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَلْبًا, everything has heart, وَقَلْبُ الْقُرْآنِ يَاسِينَ, and the heart of the Qur'an is Yasin. And there is an addition to it, وَمَنْ قَرَأَ يَاسِينَ كَتَبَ اللَّهُ لَهُ بِقِرَاءَتِهَا قِرَاءَةَ الْقُرْآنِ 10 times. And the one who read Yasin, Allah will give him the reward as if he read the whole Qur'an 10 times. Now everybody is very happy. I'm going to go and read Yasin. It's 4 pages and I'm going to get 10 times. This is a weak hadith. And some says it's very weak. And some says it is even, I don't think they said more, but they said very weak. So be very careful. But there is more than one hadith that says it is the heart of the Quran. But the second part is not, this is the only one. So be careful. That's why when we were writing the copywriter, our copywriter said, I'm going to do the title Yasin Qalb al-Quran. I said, don't do that. Because it is a weak hadith and controversial. Anything, and this is also a principle for you in this deen, anything that is controversial, stay away from it. You know why? Because there's always something better in this deen. This deen is perfect. Yani, I say it's perfect, and I'm not bragging. It is perfect. But some things may be not very, very clear, then I may use the weak one. But in general, anything that there is a controversy about it, move. You know, this dua, there is a dua from Rasul, use that dua, don't use this. As we say in Arabic, arayh rasi, exactly, peace of mind. And let me learn one thing sound about everything, then Rabbi lakalhamd. So that's the first one. This one actually by At-Tirmidhi, but he said it's a hadithun ghareeb. Now, something very interesting about the virtues of the chapters of the Quran. There's books written about virtues about the chapters. Man qara'a, who read Surah Al-Baqarah, who read whatever, who read whatever. Listen to this. It's very interesting, and I'm going to read it to you. The person who wrote that book, that the virtues of the surah, was asked, where did you get this from? Meaning, this was written later on, not at the time of Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam. So they asked him, where did you get this from? And the real Sahaba, Ikrimah and Ibn Abbas, and you say it's Ikrimah and Ibn Abbas, you say you heard it from these. And they didn't say it. They didn't write a book. Look what he said. Pay attention to this. He said, and this is later, time of Abu Hanifa. He said, I saw the people moving away from the Quran. They are now busy with what Abu Hanifa is saying. and all the expeditions that is happening, and I'm very worried about the Quran. So I fabricated this to bring people back to the Quran. So his intention is good, but he fabricated it. That's why I'm, what I'm trying to tell you, just be careful, don't say it. Be careful, make sure what you are saying is correct. So that's number one, Yasin, Qalb al-Quran. طيب. Number two, what is the most common time we read Surah Yasin? When someone died, right? That's the second one. And there is a hadith, it didn't come out of the blue. It says, اقرأوا ياسين على موتاكم. Read Yasin on or upon. Here is the question, but I'm going to translate as most of you know, and then I'll explain. على موتاكم, on the dead people. Right? In another verse, in another version of it, اقرأوها عند موتاكم. Read it when you are seeing the dead person. طيب, what is wrong with that? Hadith is very clear. It's only three words. It's very weak. The hadith is weak. Why is that? They say it's weak. Usually the weakness of the hadith is in the chain. You know the chain? Are you familiar with the chain? Again, I don't want to make it a hadith class, but just let me teach everybody because we're talking about it. So here I am, I'm saying something. Okay? You are, mashallah, tabarakallah, more than 100 women. So you all memorized one sentence from what I said. Okay? You left. You went home and you said this to your, let's say, your daughter. Your daughter memorized it. Then she said it to her friend. Or she said it to her daughter, generations. And then they ended up in the books of hadith. Bukhari, Muslim, Ibn Majah, all these books. So why it is weak then? It depends the person who is transmitting from me. A'udhu billah, I am not. But it is from Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam. There is a science, and I want you all to learn this. The science called the jarh wa ta'deel. They go through everyone, this chain, everybody in that chain, they go into their qualities. Does he forget? Is he thiqa? Is he trustworthy? A lot, again, I don't want to make it a hadith class, but this is a whole science we studied. So the problem here is in the chain, there is one person who is not a strong narrator. So the hadith becomes weak. Are you all with me? So don't we use it at all? That's another thing you have to learn. Yes, you can. You can use the weak hadith. There's so many requirements, again, to simplify it for you, as long as the content of that hadith, that's number one, does not contradict another hadith that is much stronger. For example, if there was a hadith, there isn't, but if there was a hadith that says, don't read it on your dead people, and that hadith is very strong, this hadith we're not going to use. If the hadith is in the virtues, the weak hadith, it's in virtues, it's not an act of worship, you can use it. The best part is what here is, if there is more than one weak hadith, all in the same concept, one makes the other stronger. Are you all with me? So one, so either it is very weak, the other one is very strong, contradict, we don't use it. Or three or four, same concept. Then yes, you can. So can I use this hadith? The answer is yes. Now the question, what is mawtakum? What does it mean? Dead person. Dying or dead? On the grave, when I'm washing the body, when the person is still alive, but in the last moments. Bismillah, raise your hand. I'm sorry? So last moments. How many say last moments? How about the dead? Dead too. Okay, طيب. How about on the grave? Okay, mashallah. Fuqaha un huna. Alrighty. The most common, and this I will tell you, most common is as the person is dying. Mawtakum is mostly dying. Why is that? Because there is here a statement he says, Imam Ahmad, he said this. Read it on the person who is dying. Because the subhanAllah, when the person is dying, when the soul is leaving the body, with Surah Yasin, the soul leaves the body easier. Yes, subhanAllah. Because Imam Ahmad narrated this. He said, my teachers taught me this. There was a Sahabi, a companion, who that companion was dying, reaching the last breath, but still alive. And then one of them, that's that another Sahabi said, anybody read Yasin? Anybody knows Yasin? Read it on him. And when he reached to the verse 40, that man died. And he said, it's becoming easier on him. So you read it for the dying person. That's for sure. There's no different opinion about that. The person who's dying. Have you seen somebody dying? Right? Read it. And you don't know, open the Quran writer. SubhanAllah, one of my dearest friends, dearest friend. SubhanAllah, she was dying. I read it to her. By the time I said, وَهُوَ بِكُلِّ the last verse, she died. Absolutely. The last breath went out with the last verse of Surah Yasin. We were six in that room. All of us were reading it. She was a very righteous woman. يعني سبحان الله لا إله may Allah give her more than Jannah al-Firdaws if there is. So can I read it on the dying person? The answer is yes. I read it on the dead person who already died. It's much weaker. It's much weaker. Can you make what better? Here I am. The person is dead. What does that person need from me at this moment? Exactly. Did you get the point? Let's do the things that there is no controversy. I mean, I have maybe what, 3-4 minutes with that person who's dead, right? Let me do something for sure. There is no controversy about it, right? Make the dua for the dead person, which I'm sure all of you, and if not, learn at least one, right? And should I read? If you see somebody reading it, don't say no. Because again, it is not fabricated hadith. It's a weak hadith. I mean, a little bit weaker. And the meaning of mawtakum, that's where they differ on it. Is that clear? Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. طيب. Now, yes. I'm sorry? I can't hear you. No. It's on the grave in general is you make dua. You make dua. You make dua for the person because the person is hearing you. And also, of course, if you can, or and for us, usually, rarely we go, but usually make dua. The person after they die, what they need is my dua. And in that moment when they are in the grave, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for all of us. So another hadith, maybe some of you not familiar is, he said the following, من قرأ ياسين في صدر النهار قضيت حوائجه. Whomsoever read Yasin in the beginning of the day, everything he needs in that day will be given. Do you know this hadith? Okay, that is very weak. أصلاً هو مرسل هذا الحديث. Meaning, this hadith is not for sure connected to Rasul عليه الصلاة والسلام. It's في سنن الدارمي. But I'm sharing all this with you because you will hear it. So when you hear it, don't say it. It is not, you say, you know what? I'm not sure. You know what I'm saying? Let's not fight each other. Let's learn Surah Yasin. Instead of fighting, go and learn it and memorize it and use it the way you feel you are comfortable from everything I am sharing. The other one, هذا في البيهقي. من قرأ ياسين, again, subhanAllah, this is very few surahs in the Quran that many. من قرأ ياسين, who reads Surah Yasin, what will happen? Number one, what's your intention? For the sake of Allah. For the sake of Allah. All the sins will be forgiven. غُفِرَ لَهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِهِ All the sins will be forgiven. فَقْرَأُوهَا عِنْدَ مَوْتَاكُمْ Read it on the dying person. Because that person, the sins also will be forgiven. Because you are reading for the sake of Allah. But it's also a weak hadith. Did you get enough weak hadith? It's all, yeah, there is no single sound hadith about Surah Yasin. I told you this, right? But these are not fabricated. These are not, he didn't say it, but they are very weak. So we have to be, some weak, some are very weak. So we have to be careful about that. Okay, what else?
And there's also, they say, read 41 times.
When we come to numbers, because that's also another very common things in everywhere in the world, not only in one part of the world. If there is a hadith on sahih, about numbers, don't hesitate. For example, morning and evening in the adhkar, we say, Salah ala Nabi, how many times? 10 times there is a hadith about it. After salat al-fajr, after salat al-maghrib, you read قل هو الله أحد. How many times? Why? He said so. And the hadith is صحيح. That's, but if you come and tell me, let's come together and send 500 salawat على النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام, you know what my answer will be? Why not 501? Why not 450? So don't specify numbers unless the numbers is related, supported by a hadith. Again, I'm going to say the same thing. Why do I want to do something? Versus, you know what? I'm just going to send salawat ala nabi alayhi salatu wasalam. Don't worry about the numbers. Numbers, Allah is calculating. Angels are writing. Instead of saying, I'm going to say this number and this number may be an issue. Are you all with me? So we just need to look at things in a different way. Again, don't attack people. Don't say this. Don't use the word bid'ah, please. Not you. And I really, I'm being very honest and frank. The word bid'ah has to be said by people who really have knowledge. And they know what bid'ah mean and what really is bid'ah. You stay away from this. As you know what? I'm just going to, somebody says, let's do 500. I said, I'm going to do salawat ala nabi till I have no more breath. Ya Allah. Are you all with me? Alhamdulillah. I'm sorry. Alaykum salam.
There is a hadith where they say when you read the Surah Al-Baqarah,
I said it. It's okay. Please pay attention. Already? Yes. من قرأ سورة ياسين في الليلة غفر له ذنبه. It's the same idea. Right? So there is the three things. Now let's summarize so you don't get confused. There's the three things said about Surah Yasin related to actions. Number one is related to death and dying. Why is that? Because in it, and we will probably next week we'll learn it, is the person who his people killed him. When he was killed, he didn't say anything. He says, Ya layta qawbi ya'lamun. If my people only know what Allah prepared for me. Make the life of the person who is dying easier. Meaning, imagine this. Now, we don't know when the person is dying. Do they hear? We don't know. This is all in the unseen. But imagine you are saying, Ya layta qawmi ya'lamun bima ghafara li rabbi. Meaning, don't worry, Allah will forgive you. And then the next thing is all about ashab al-jannah. How is that person dying will feel? Again, we don't know. But imagine you or me. Then I will do that. That's number one. Number two, it is related to forgiveness of the sins. Weak hadith. But it's okay. Read it, but don't say it is. Now I read Yasin, Allah will forgive me. Because some scholars will tell you, anytime you read the Quran, it's a good deed. And Allah will forgive you. Done. Okay? Now, another one is, من داوم هذا منكر. This is rejected. من داوم على قراءتها كل ليلة. ثم مات مات شهيدا. Whomsoever read it every night and then dies will die as a martyr. That's rejected. This is not there. Munkar هذا أو موضوع I think. يعني fabricated. Also, this is another one fabricated. من دخل المقابر. Whomsoever enter the graveyard. فقرأ سورة ياسين then read سورة ياسين خفف عنهم يومئذ that day all the those who are in this graveyard that day their life will be easier in the grave وكان له بها بعدد من فيها حسنات and as many as there are, the graves are in that graveyard he will get the rewards fabricated he didn't say that so let's stay on It's a virtuous surah. It reminds the most important thing I need to read, to learn, is that there is a lot of great lessons in it. That's why there is so many talks about its virtues. The main thing is, yes, read it on your dying people. And if somebody tells you, no, I don't read it, that's also absolutely fine. Right? قلب القرآن. Scholar says why it is the heart of the Quran. There's no other surah in the Quran, Allah said, or I mean, the Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam, or someone said, it's the heart. Why Yasin? It's not in the middle, so don't worry. It's not in the middle of the Quran. It's actually that I just told you, it's 22nd and 23rd. Why? طيب. Let me give you a clue. What is the heart in the body? The beat. What is a beating me? I know it's beating. What is beating me? I'm sorry, one person raise your hand. Yes, please.
It's an organ which keeps the person alive.
طيب. So why Yasin is قلب القرآن? Again, we said it's a weak hadith, but I need to know the concept because I'm going to learn from that concept. So when I look at Yasin, I was like, there is something in Surah Yasin. Allah wants me to learn. There's a possibility it was said that it's the heart of the Quran. Are you all with me? يعني احنا, we want to go deeper to learn the virtue, to learn it. What do I need to learn from it? So what is it other than you? Anybody else? Yes. I love the youth. Yes. So maybe it is called, I'm just saying it again so everybody can hear. Maybe it is called the heart of the Quran because like in the Quran, when the heart start pumping, will push blood all over. Okay, and?
Really deep or really
like, okay, so did you get the point? So it's doing what the heart does in the body. There's more than that. You all said it, but I was looking for a word. Yes. Okay, so without it the body will die, meaning it's the source of life to the body, right? So why they are seen as the source of the life to the Quran and to us? I'm sorry? Hard reading? No, Surah Yasin is very easy to read, by the way. Absolutely, it's not hard. On the contrary, and it's very, I wouldn't say it's very easy to memorize because it may be a little bit, there's a lot of similarities, but it is absolutely and not difficult to understand. There's no words that is what, right? But what is it that Allah wants me? Okay, I'm going to give you the clue. Are you all ready? Bismillah. I'm going to give you, okay, I'm sorry, you were raising your hand. Please forgive me. Yes.
Is it because life and death is
both? Exactly. That's one of the things. It talks about life and death in way, not anywhere else in the Quran. There is no other place in the Quran, the whole Quran, where the person who died, and a human being, not a prophet, a human being, we don't even know the name. وَجَاءَ مَنْ أَخْصَى الْمَدِينَةِ رَجُلٌ A man from the far... No, not a man. From the faraway place in the village, a man came. Who is this man? Meaning ordinary person. But there is in it, is telling me, ah, if only my people know. What does it mean? Your real life is where? I want to hear it. There. It's there. That's one. Second, it's scary. It's there is in it. Verses that is scary. I need to be scared to stay alive. All of us, natural in us, we have the instinct of fear, right? Why? Just to be afraid and panic? No, because fear does what? The norm fear, the justified fear, protect my life. Meaning, when you get to the outlet, electric outlet, and you see a 2 or 3 year old running to it, what do you normally do? You're scared. Why? Because he can or she can get hurt. You move. So when they are seen in the middle of it, Allah is talking about scenes from Jahannam. Ah, wake up. Then arguments of human being. أَوَلَمْ يَرَى الْإِنسَانِ Don't the human being see what did we created him from? And then the argument, well, you say there's other places there is argument. It's true, but this one, there is a dialogue. We'll come to it when we go to it. So there is in it, there's no stories of prophets. It's very interesting. Even no mention of a Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam, mentioned indirectly, but no name. Because the concept is, that's why Allah knows, but one of the reasons who reads it every single day, because if you keep reading it, and not reading it when you don't know what you are saying, you're reading it and you know and you reflect, it will change you. When I will come, inshallah, to the scientific miracle about the moon, you will say, subhanallah, how can I not believe? and how Allah used the words. حتى عاد كل عرجون القديم, هذه scientific miracle, people was like wow. So the idea is, don't hold, and I will stop here so I can take if you have questions. What I'm trying to say is, don't hold to the superficial things that create issues. Learn from the message. Learn from the message. I need now, inshallah, bi-idhnillah, after today, look at Yasin differently. It's not like, oh, somebody is dead, read Yasin. Ah, I'm not dead. Do I need to read Yasin? Yeah. I need to read all the Quran, but when I come to Yasin, I'm going to focus on 1, 2, and 3, and 4. The main messages of it is literally wake up, people. We created you from nothing, and you will end up in this short span, you will end up there. And there either you are living in joy and bliss, or you are living in, literally, in hell. That's the word there. So that's the overall summary of Surah Yasin, the virtues of it. And then inshallah from next week, bi-idhnillah, we're going to go through it. Probably we're going to spend at least 4 weeks. Because again, it's very popular between everybody, and we need to really know it, feel it. Inshallah, bi-idhnillah, those of you who are planning to memorize, put it as a goal for Ramadan. It's very easy. It's only 4 pages, 4.5. So put it as a, is it 4? 6 total with the half? Yeah. Yani 5.5. Yeah, 5.5. Right? So make it 5.5. Yani if you memorize per week 1 page, by the end of Ramadan, you're almost there. So put a goal, and again, no hadith about the virtue of memorizing it. But in general, when we memorize, we pay more attention to the words, more attention to the meaning. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ya Rabbi Ameen, make us from those who listen to the words of admonition, follow it, make us, ya Rabbi Ameen, more attached to the Quran, makes the Quran our heart. Not Yasin qalb al-Quran, the whole Quran is our heart, and in our heart, ya Rabbi Ameen. Subhanak Allahumma wa bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Sallallahu ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa ashabi tasliman kathira. Any questions? Yes, bismillah. Okay, please, can we not have a conversations on the side? Please, may Allah reward you. So in the Indo-Pak culture, when someone dies, they all have Quran Khani. That's a different story. It's a different story. Right. It has three, this, the usual, it has a scale. That one end of the scale, it's a bid'ah. That you will hear it from many people. Rasulullah didn't do it. This is an act of worship. If this was good, he would have done it. It's not done. Bid'ah, done. That's one. Others, they will tell you, no, it's your bringing people together to read the Quran, it's virtuous. The middle, why you are doing it. You really have to understand these things, why you are doing it. Why you are doing it. I want to hear it, because many people does that. Why you are doing it? Well, they invited me. I just said, I want to hear it. The reward of what? So I'm reading the Quran. What's Quran Khani for those of you who don't know? People get together, someone dies. After the death, then people get together, right? Certain day, again, because we are very busy, one day say, you know what? We're going to do, they call it Quran Khani in the Indo-Pak. In here we say Jasad Quran in the Arabic world, in the Arab world. We're going to get together, read the Quran. What is wrong with that? Right? We're reading Quran. طيب. Why it's bid'ah? Then why it is, some people say it's innovation. So the first question you have to ask yourself, it's your niyyah, your intention. I can't label everything as bid'ah. What is my intention? I asked you, because of the reward, right? Reward of whom and what? Reward of whom and what? I want to hear it. Raise your hand. Yes. The Jannah for the dead, by reading the Quran when they are dead. One juz. Are you with me? So if I am coming, right, to console the family, and then I'm going to read one part of the Quran, and I'm going to gift the reward to the dead person, alhamdulillah, there's nothing wrong with that. But if we are getting together to do a khatma of the Quran, And each one will read one part. That's not a khatma. The khatma is that the person has to have read it all. Did you get the point? That's what they say. One of the reasons they say it's bid'ah. So if I go and I'm reading and I'm saying, you know, I'm reading Al-Baqarah, I'm going to give the gift of me reading Al-Baqarah to that person. But I'm not going to say at the end, we did a khatma and we make a dua of a khatma. Because khatma is the person has to read it all. Right? Are you all with me? Like when you are in Ramadan, you are in Ramadan. If the imam skip one surah, what do you say? We didn't do khatam. Right? We all say this and we complain. What happened? It's the same. So look at your niyyah and look at what you want to do. And then, can I do something better again? Analyze it wisely. Can I do something better for that person and get out of the controversy? Yeah, I can stay home and I can read two or three or four ajza without even nobody knows, which even is better, and send it to that person and make a lot of dua. Can I go and give condolences to the people? Yes, you should, but I'm not going to be part of it. It's up to you. You don't want to be part of it. Did you get it? And if we can all as a community move from the things that may be bid'ah, whatever, to things that is not, then we are absolutely on the safe side. Did that answer the question? I will leave it to you. Yeah, because I told you the three scale. If there was no other opinions, I would have said absolutely no. Absolutely no. But some people says, if you're sitting there, the niyyah is getting together, reviewing the Quran, you give the reward for one juz you did, then that's okay. So when people ask me, I said, up to you. You decide what you want to do. But don't say we did khatma for thee. Not only in death. Sometimes people just like, let's come and do a khatma and everybody wants. Well, we didn't read it all. We didn't read it all in one sitting. One person didn't read it all. I read one juz. I didn't do a khatma. I did one or two or whatever I did. Okay. Any other question? You can read whatever you want to read. It's all Quran. It's all beautiful. Whatever you want to read. So I'm going to end the live stream.